take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll start it on the ground with Morris. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. To throw, Fitzpatrick. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
Well, Charles, while we have a second, you know, we talked about the NFC playoff picture, but I wanted to get your thoughts on a hot topic right now in NFL circles. That's awarding a home game to every division winner, regardless of record. It's happened twice in this decade that we've seen a 7-9 team in Seattle get a home game and a 7-8-1 Carolina team get one. Where do you stand on this? Because there's a scenario where you could have a 13-win team from the NFC West traveling to face an 8-win team from the NFC East.
I know I'm a dinosaur on this one. Absolutely. I love the division champ getting a home game. I don't care what the record is, and I know it sounds wrong, and we're in this society now where everything has to be fair and right. And we would like that, and I would like that too for most big topics. But in sports, it's actually kind of cool when these things happen. Remember, Seattle at 7-9 hosted the defending Super Bowl champs, New Orleans, and beat them. That big Marshawn Lynch run that we'll remember forever. Carolina 7-8-1, they actually lost at home in their playoff game. So you don't know how it's going to turn. I like division champs winning it and getting a home game, even when the records are kind of messed up.
I'm with you. You're making me smile.
How about that? You and I sitting in the home, two old dudes going, that's the way it ought to be.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. It's caught. Jones. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's first and 10. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Luck now, perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, Luck. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. From 3 yards out, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
And now he's at that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's to sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
one of
she's
our guys.
Singing too.
Oh, she's singing. She, yeah,
she's
at least,
on like the fifth tune. At
yeah,
this point.
She left scales way behind. But he's to sing something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. The Broncos on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Fitzpatrick to throw it. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. To the air again, Fitzpatrick completes it to Hearns. A gain of six there on first.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On second and 11 now. Fitzpatrick caught by Allen. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. He finds Roberts, complete. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A first down throw for Fitzpatrick. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one.
And oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. The intended receiver there, Allen. And that pick just sets him up beautifully right down near the goal line.
I remember being in a defensive meeting back when I was in college, and our defensive coordinator says, we're going to call this be who you are defense. D lineman, you play the run.
And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. And my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you totally. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in the trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
This one fielded at the 5. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Right back for Adam. This time he finds him complete. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. This defense tightening up a bit. That last catch just 1 yard, making it 3rd and 9. Here's Fitzpatrick. Roberts has it. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That's it, baby. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Fitzpatrick now, firing quickly here, and that's complete. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll make it a 2nd down. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Again, it's Fitzpatrick. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Denver. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. He's going to field this at the four. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis on hand. Kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best? To give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game. That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
Now the big leg of Matt Prater ready to get this one started. And we are underway here on EA Sports. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. Accelerating and off he goes. Touchdown, Cowboys. That kick return TD is 90. 90-